Good afternoon, student. Today you wrote Grand Test 11. In that we are going to discuss about zoology. So starting from question number 136, select an incorrect match. So first option, phenylketonuria autosomal recessive disorder, right? So phenylketonuria is the autosomal recessive disorder. So that's correct option. Second option is muscular dystrophy. So muscular dystrophy is a skeletal disorder. So this is related with this allosomal recessive disorder. So this is also we called as autosomal recessive disorder. Both will come. So the second option is correct, allosomal recessive disorder. So first option is also correct. And third option, Klinefelter syndrome. So this is a chromosomal syndrome. So sex-linked chromosomal disorder. This is correct only. So then last one, myotonic dystrophy. Myotonic dystrophy is also skeletal disorder. This is a autosomal recessive disorder. But instead of that, they have to give autosomal dominant disorder. Actually, myotonic dystrophy is the autosomal dominant disorder. That's what out of four options, which is incorrect, they are asking. So which is that incorrect? Fourth is the incorrect statement. For this question number 136, answer will be fourth option. So next move to question number 137. Although India has only 2.4% of the world's land area, its share of the global species diversity is an impressive. How much percentage they are asking? So how much percentage? Direct answer, 8.1%. 8.1% we have global species diversity. In world total, 12 mega diversity countries to be there. So in our world, especially out of 12, India is also one of the mega diversity country. So why? Because of our global species diversity will be very impressive. That is having of about 8.1%. So first option is the correct answer for this question 137. So next to move to question number 138. So question number 138, column 1 and 2 are there. In column 1, matching is there. So in column 1, Montreal Protocol. So Montreal Protocol is related with this reduction in greenhouse gases, zero waste process, slash and burn technique, and second one is fourth one is reduction in ODS, right? So Montreal Protocol is reduction in ozone depleting substance. ODS means what? Ozone depleting substance. So Montreal Protocol is related to ozone. Then second one, zoom cultivation. You have already studied in biodiversity environmental issues na, zoom agricultural technique. Then followed by C, Kyoto Protocol. So Kyoto Protocol is related to emission in greenhouse gases. Then followed by fourth one, D, organic farming is related to zero waste process. So A4, B3, C1 and D2. So option fourth will be the correct answer for this question number 138. So now move to question number 139. So what they have given in 139, Hizzard Ale. So this is a new bred species. So is a new bred of sheep developed in Punjab from crossing between the Bikaneri Avis and Merino Rams. So what you will get? So this category of breed is developed by outbreeding, outcrossing, crossbreeding, and then followed by interspecific hybridization. You have already studied different breeding techniques now. So out of different breeding technique, Hizzard Ale is majorly got from which technique? Crossbreeding. So crossbreeding is nothing but so cross between the two individuals of two different breeds will be there, and they'll get the one of the new breed is called Hizzard Ale. Then in first option, what they give? Outbreeding. So outbreeding is related to cross between the two individuals. These are not closely related species. not closely related species when you will cross na. So that type of breeding technique is called outbreeding. So then followed by outcrossing. So outcrossing in the sense between the, maybe between the same breed, but no common ancestor, of four to six generation, you will not find the common ancestor. So that is what we called as outcrossing. Then followed by third option is the correct answer. And interspecific hybridization is nothing but breeding between the two individuals of different species. So different species, or we'll also call it as unrelated, cross between the two unrelated species is called interspecific hybridization. So this is what you have to remember. 139 is the third option. Then followed by 148th question. Cocaine is obtained from a plant called Erythroxylum coca and has a potent stimulating action on central nervous system. It interferes with the transport of which neurotransmitter? So this cocaine is related to release of which neurotransmitter? They are asking, transmitter name is called dopamine. So dopamine is a one of the excitatory neurotransmitter will be there. So in response, when they will take, person will snort or any method, when they will take this cocaine, that directly stimulates the CNS, and thereby releasing of a chemical takes place. So that chemical is called dopamine. So other chemicals to be there, so but releasing of dopamine takes place. So other chemicals, neurotransmitter like glycine will be there, adrenaline will be there, acetylcholine will be there. So all these are neurotransmitters only. So when they will take, specially cocaine, releasing of dopamine takes place. So next, followed by question number 141, find out the correct statement. So what they have given in first option, roundworms are circular in cross section. Correct only, na? Elementary canal with muscular pharynx. Correct only, na? Then true coelom. So true coelomates you will find from Annelida. So these roundworms are pseudo coelomates. Instead of this true coelomates, so pseudo coelomate they have given as true coelomate. So this is wrong statement. Then followed by second one, arthropods. Arthropods will have open circulation. Correct only. Then excretion through bugills. No, bugills are the respiratory organs, right? Respiratory organs, not excretory organ. So that's what, fertilization is generally external. So but bugills are the respiratory organ. So this is also wrong one. So third option, hemichordata. So hemichordata, excretion through proboscis gland. Correct only. Circulation is open type. Correct only. Exclusively marine. All these statements are correct. And third option is correct. And what they gave in that fourth option? Echinodermata. Echinodermata will have chitinous ossicles? No. Instead of chitinous ossicles, they have tried calcareous. Endoskeleton is made up of, body is made up of, epidermis is made up of calcareous ossicles. So cesocoelomate. Actually, echinoderms are enterocoelomates. They have enterocoelom. So that's what, this is also wrong one. Excretory system is correct again. So but these two are wrong one. So option 3 will be the correct answer for this 141. So next, followed by question number 142. What they gave? Chondrionthes differ from osteonthes in all except. So these two are same except which one? Mainly marine and viviparous. No. Why? Because both are not marine. So cartilaginous fishes are marine, but osteonthes are, some are marine and some are freshwater. So all are not viviparous. So some are viviparous, some are oviparous in osteonthes, but in chondrionthes, all are, almost all species are viviparous. This is wrong one. Second option, mouth is ventral. No, in one species, one fish type, mouth is ventral. In another, mouth is terminal. Gill slits without operculum in some, with operculum in some species. Body is covered by scales. In both the body, scaling will be there. This is correct only. And both are cold-blooded. So both statements are related to, no difference in these two. Then fourth one, again difference is there. What is that? Swim constantly to avoid sinking due to absence of swim bladder. This is to be there in cartilaginous fishes, but in bony fishes this facility to be there. So that is nothing but presence of air bladder or swim bladder to be there. So due to presence of this swim bladder, they can have this buoyancy, but in this cartilaginous fishes buoyancy will be not there. So in out of four option, which is not a difference, both will be common, means body scales are common in both, and the cold blooded or pyclothermic nature will be there in both. So option 3 will be the correct answer for 142. So next move to question number 143. So what they give, following is the list of organisms and their zoological names. Find out the correct combination. Balaenoptera, scientifically zoological name is nothing but what? Scientific name. Balaenoptera, blue whale, fourth one, A4. Aptenodite, commonly called penguin, one. Pterophyllum, scientifically called, commonly called angelfish. Then ichthyophis, commonly called limbless amphibian. So this vulture will be the extra one. So what will happen here? A4, B1, C2, D3. So now first option will be the correct answer with their zoological names. So first option. Then move to question number 144. Tendons attaches to skeletal muscles to bone is an example for. Tendon and ligaments comes under dense connective tissue. Which connective? Dense connective tissue. So in a dense connective tissue, two will come: dense connective regular and dense connective irregular. So again in dense connective regular, you will find different types. So tendons. So in this only again fibrous tissues and elastic you will find. So in that fibrous again you will find tendon and ligament. So you have to remember. So in which it will come means dense regular white fibrous connective tissue. Example of this tendon and ligament comes under this dense regular white fibrous connective tissue. So next followed by question number 145. Which junctions facilitates the cells to communicate with each other by connecting the cytoplasm of adjoining cells for rapid transfer of ions, small molecules and sometimes big molecules? Especially in a definition only they have mentioned it in between the adjoining cells it has. So long gap will be there, and that gap will be helpful for rapid transfer of ions. Any ions you can take, rapid transfer takes place between the two cells. Why? Because of between adjoining cell you are finding a gap will be there. That's what, on that base only we are calling it as which junction? Gap junction, right? So tight junction in the sense in between the two adjacent cell you are not finding the any gap. So that's what we are calling it as tight junction. Adhering means in between these two adjacent cells you will find a small gap will be there, that also involved in leaking of only small or little molecular weight molecule transfer takes place. But in gap junction, so large molecules also takes place. Then followed by fourth option, hemidesmosome. Hemidesmosomes you will find between the adhering junctions. Next, question number 146. The development of periplaneta, P stands for periplaneta. Periplaneta americana is having a larval stage is called a porometabolus. That is through nymphal stage formation. How many times molding occurs in nymph to reach the adult form? So usually in cockroach study we have already studied so many times now. So this is how the larval form will be there in cockroaches. Usually cockroaches will undergo porometabolus type of development. So that is how many times? 13 times. When that small organism will undergo 13 times molding, so when reaches to the 14th time it will become adult cockroach after 14. after 14th molt, and thereby they have completely well-developed wings, you will find. Well-developed wings. Right, in nymphal stage, so development of wing will be not there. After completing this porometabolous development, they'll get the true wings. So next, 147. Enzymes that catalyze the removal of groups from substrate and by mechanism other than the hydrolysis, leaving the double bonds. The name itself says that, so removal of the group atom by from an substrate without hydrolysis, without breaking the bond, leaving bond as it is means they are leaving, it means that without breaking the bond. So such type of enzymes are called lyases. Isomerases means biochemical reaction takes place by changing in its geometry. So then ligases means union of molecule. Union of molecule takes place during catalysis process. Dehydrogenase, removal of hydrogen group. Removal of hydrogen in these enzymes. So next move to question number 148. The wall of elementary canal possesses different layers. Mark the exact arrangement from inner to outer side in stomach region. So from inner to outer means we should go from mucosa. Mucosa is the innermost layer. So from next to mucosa will be submucosa. Submucosa. Next to submucosa, especially normally other parts of the elementary canal means oblique will not come. Especially they have mentioned here stomach. Stomach means next to submucosa, oblique layer will come. So that's what here, submucosa, then followed by oblique. Oblique layer, thick muscle will be there involved in peristalsis, then followed by circular muscles. After circular, longitudinal muscles. After longitudinal, serosa will come. Longitudinal and circular togetherly forms muscularis. Muscularis is the second layer. In that muscularis, inner circular layer and outer longitudinal. So outer to that, outermost layer is called serosa. First option. So next move to question number 140. Small quantity of chain of fatty acids reach up to the bloodstream by following pathway. Usually fatty acids and glycerol, how they will pass there directly, they won't reach to the bloodstream. Instead of that, so first small protein, it will form a globular structure called micelles. Micelles will undergo protein coating. After protein coating, we'll call it as chylomicrons. After converting into chylomicrons, these chylomicrons first absorbed by lacteals. Lacteals are nothing but lymph vessels. After reaching to lymph vessels, then only it reaches to the bloodstream, blood capillaries. Blood, from there, blood capillary, it reaches to the different parts of the body where it has to be stored. So where it will store, na? So there it reaches and excess fat will get stored there in adipose tissue or in different parts of the body. So option second will be the correct answer for this question. So next move to very easy this one. Every 100 ml of oxygenated blood can deliver around 5 ml of oxygen to the tissues under normal physiological condition provided in tissues. There is, whenever dissociation curve may like this. So during when that oxygen will carry and when it reaches to nearer to the tissues, for example, you consider this is a tissue. So what will happen immediately in tissues, PCO2 will be more. Arrow mark I am showing upside. It means that, so PCO2 means partial pressure of carbon dioxide is more, then followed by what will happen? High H plus ion concentration will be there, low pH will be there, right? So PO2 is less, 3 or more, and PO2 will be less in tissue. So due to all these factors, so what will happen? That dissociation curve may like this. So that's what dissociation of oxyhemoglobin takes place. It means that Hb plus O2, it will be reversible HbO2. When it reaches nearer to the tissue, once again it will dissociate into H++ of O2. O2 will get delivered to the tissues, tissues will get utilized, and that hemoglobin will retains as it is in the blood, and thereby it carries once again carbon dioxide while going. So now this answer will be high PCO2 and high H+ ion concentration to be there in tissues. That is responsible for what? So dissociation of oxyhemoglobin. So next, followed by 151. Unmyelinated nerve fibers are commonly found in autonomous and somatic neural system. Usually in somatic neural system and in ANS, unmyelinated. Unmyelin is nothing but myelin sheath won't be there. So absence of myelin sheath. As absence of myelin sheath. So usually due to absence of myelin sheath only, we are calling it as unmyelinated nerve fiber. So but in that, you have to remember that Schwann cells only forms the myelin sheath. But this myelin sheath only not there means Schwann cells are not there, like that you will think, but not like that. In unmyelinated nerve fibers, you will find the Schwann cells are to be there, but Schwann cells won't produce or secretes the myelin sheath. So that's what for this question answer will be the myelin sheath. Absence of myelin sheath, but presence of Schwann cells to be there. So next, move to question number 152. So what is there in this? Which of the following is the correct description of a certain part of the normal human skeleton? So human skeleton, what are the different part explanation is there, which is correct? We should find out that. So first option is parietal bone and temporal bone of skull are joined by fibrous joint. So fibrous joint will also call it as immovable joint. Usually in skull, na, which type of joint will be there means you have to remember that immovable joint. Another name, fibrous joint. So that first option is the correct one. Second option, first vertebrae axis. No, first vertebrae atlas. Wrong one. Which articulates with the occipital condyle. So atlas they have to give. So that's the wrong one. Then third one, 9th and 10th pairs of ribs are called floating ribs. So not 9th and 10th. So actually instead of that, 10th and 11th and 12th. So these two are called floating ribs instead of 9th and 10th. So first 7 are true, right? Second one. So first 7, 8 and 9 and 10, 11th and 12th floating ribs. So they have to give. And last option, glenoid cavity is a depression to which the thigh bone articulate. So usually in glenoid cavity, which articulation will be there? Humerus. Shoulder joint will be there. Instead of shoulder joint, they have given as thigh bone. So thigh bone for this acetabulum is there. Where in that acetabulum fixing of the thigh bone takes place. So this is what the answer for this question number 152. First option is correct. Remaining three all the not correct for this. So three options are wrong. First option is correct. So next, move to question number 153. Heart muscle work throughout life without getting this fatigueness. Why? Because of usually long refractory period would be there. So long refractory period in the sense what? That is a period next to the next stimulation. What is that period will be there for that next stimulation? That's what we called as refractory period. So that is very longest refractory period you will find in cardiac muscles. More myoglobin. So myoglobin is very necessary. Oxygen having pigment will be there, like how the hemoglobin is there, respiratory pigment in hemoglobin, like that only here in muscle hemoglobin, we'll commonly calling it as myoglobin. So myoglobin will store the excess oxygen in the muscles for future use. So that is also correct. So they undergo aerobic respiration, no formation of lactic acid, usually in except heart muscle, usually in heart muscle, aerobic respiration will be there, no lactic acid formation. That's what all four options are correct for this question 153. Next 154. In all of the following conditions, the glucose will appear in the urine except. So glucose, when that glucose will comes along with this urine, means when diabetes will be more. So like that, some conditions they have given. So we should choose. If kidney is unable to absorb all amount of glucose present in the glomerular filters, this is also correct only. So when it will not having high threshold, glucose comes under high threshold substances. When high threshold substance, in the sense in glomerular filters, in PCT, 100% absorption takes place. If it is not fair, if it is fails to absorb 100% in the PCT, that remaining will not undergo reabsorption in different kidney tubule. That's what it will come as it is along with the urine. So this is also condition glucose will come. Second option, if glucose content in the blood plasma is more than 250 mg per 100 ml. In diabetic patients, when it exceeds more than 250 mg, it may lead to that excess glucose may also come out along with the urine. That is also correct only. So next, followed by during pregnancy, when glomerular filtration rate is high. So during pregnancy, when GFR rate will goes on increases, similar way absorption decreases. If absorption decreases, once again that excess glucose will come out along with the urine. So this is also correct only. So fourth option, if a person undergone prolonged hunger strike, it means that if the person is not at all eating, means in him what will happen, hunger strike will goes on increases. So in them what will happen, release of a hormone takes place, that hormone is called glucagon. Which is that glucagon? Glucagon is antagonistic to insulin. Insulin may convert what? Glucose into glycogen, that will store in the muscles and also in the liver. But this is antagonistic, agonist one. So what it will do, glucagon? So conversion of, once again, stored glycogen into glucose. Why this will convert this hormone? So when it releases, means only when the person is not getting sufficient food, means at that condition releasing of the glucagon, that released glucagon may convert glycogen into glucose, then only will maintain the blood glucose level. So this is in prolonged condition, it may not exceed more than 250. So that's what in prolonged it will not excrete. It will not excrete glucose along with the urine. So fourth option is the correct answer. So next, move to 155. Which of the following will not occur in response to decrease in the blood volume and blood pressure? So more secretion of ADH. More secretion of ADH means, once again, blood volume may increase, not decrease. This is correct only. Is it or not? This is a wrong statement to that question. More secretion of aldosterone. If more secretion of aldosterone is there, BP increases, not decreases. BP increases. So if more secretion of renin is there, again BP increases. They're asking not occur in response to decrease. So more secretion of ANF. More secretion of ANS may lead to decrease in BP and blood volume. So fourth option is the correct answer, but remaining first three options may leads to increased BP and increased blood volume, except fourth option, ANF may decrease the blood volume and BP. So next, 157. There are many contraceptive methods used to control fertility. None of these method is 100% reliable. Which method has maximum number of failure? So out of four option, they are asking that which one will be having more failure. So which one is there in these four? Vasectomy is there, periodic abstinence is there, oral pill is there, IUD is there. So vasectomy is having more than 90% success rate is there. Why? Because completely, if they'll completely cut and remove this vasa deferens, part of vasa deferens means no chances of released sperm may reach this ejaculatory duct. So this is one plus point is there. It won't be 100%. So or 90% success rates to be there. Periodic abstinence is a natural method. So calendar methods to be there. Here chances are very less. That's what failure chances are more to this. Failure chances are more. Why? Because we are not using any contraceptive. That's what. So these chances are more. Then third one, oral pill. Oral pills like you can take Malady. These are combined pills, right? Malady you can take, or Mala N you can take, or emergency pills you can take, I pill you can take, pill 72 you can take, unwanted 72 you can take. So all these are the different emergency pills. All these are the combined pills to be there, or mini pill like Saheli you can take. All these are the tablets will have more than 50% of the success rates to be there. So that's for failure chances are less compared with this periodic abstinence. So then followed by IUD. So you will find different IUDs like copper releasing will be there, CUT, CU7 or multi-load 372 you will find, or you can take lips loop, you can take non-medicated will be there. Is it or not? So progestacert you can take. All these are the different forms of this IUDs, types of IUDs will be there. All these will also have the good results to be there compared with this periodic abstinence. So that's what for this question, second option will be the correct answer. Means failure chances are more in that. Next followed by 158. Which of the following protozoan parasite causes STD characterized by false smelling, yellowish vaginal discharge and burning sensation during urination? Neisseria gonorrhoeae is a bacterial STD. You have to remember bacterial STD. It will cause a disease, gonorrhea or gonorrhea. Next, Trichomonas vaginalis. This is a protozoan STD. This is correct one. They're asking protozoan. Here they have mentioned that. So clear you have to observe. Then third one, chlamydia. So this is also bacterial infection. Then Treponema pallidum. This is also bacterial infection. So three are bacterial, one is protozoan. Which is that protozoan? Trichomonas vaginalis. If you are not getting answer, one more easy trick will be there. So what is that trick? There are directly they have given in question itself, vaginal discharge related with that, Trichomonas vaginalis. Like that also you can remember if you are not getting the scientific names and which causative agent, like that. Next, 159. Menstruation is triggered by abrupt is nothing but sudden decline in the amount of progesterone. Correct answer. Is it or not? So whenever menstruation takes place, after that, so finally ovulation takes place, after ovulation corpus luteum will develop. So this corpus luteum will undergo degeneration. If any fertilization is there, then only it will retain, otherwise it will undergo degeneration. So that during degeneration process, secretion of progesterone will completely decline. Is it or not? So fourth option is correct one. 160. ACTH stimulates the synthesis and secretion of steroidal hormones of adrenal cortex, except so glucocorticoid and cortisol both same only. Then sex corticoid, gonadocorticoids. We'll also call it as gonadocorticoids. Then third option is mineralocorticoid like aldosterone. So aldosterone is a mineral balance maintaining in the body fluid, especially in plasma, that is by release of a hormone called aldosterone, which is not that much under the influence of this ACTH compared to remaining three. 160, third option. So next followed by matches will be there, column 1 and 2. Melatonin will maintains the sleep-wake cycle, that is normal rhythms. body temperature and also menstrual cycle. A2, Kolob's hormone. Another name of Kolob's hormone. Kolob's hormone, will also call it as parathyroidal hormone. Parathormone or reabsorption of calcium. Parathormone function what? Reabsorption of calcium in blood. Glucocorticoid will undergo breakdown of lipid, protein and glucose. Then followed by vasopressin will prevent the diuresis. Diuresis means what? One who will suffer from excess urination, or he is urinating more amount of this, or more output of urine will be there, means that disease condition is called diuresis, or will also call it as diabetes insipidus. Insipidus, this is what you have to remember. So for this question, now answer A2, B3, C1 and D4. Correct answer. So next, move to question number 162. The third ventricle consists of narrow channel between the hemispheres connected to the midbrain part of the brainstem to fourth ventricle. It means that, so which cavity will be attaching with this midbrain part of brainstem to fourth ventricle? So they are asking in this question. So cerebral aqueduct, iter, foramen of Monroe, both 1 and 2. So direct answer in NCERT also they have mentioned this. Fourth option, cerebral aqueduct, another name will also call it as iter, that connects the third ventricle with fourth ventricle. Then one more option they have given, foramen of Monroe. Foramen of Monroe, it connects two lateral ventricles to third ventricle. Third ventricle. It means that, so first and second ventricles are connected to the third ventricle with the help of another cavity is called foramen of Monroe. So next, move to question number 163. Which statement is not suitable to the NK cells? NK cell means what? Natural killer cell. What it will kill? Later we'll discuss. So first option, they are included in cytokine barrier. So no. So these NK cells comes under cellular barrier. This is wrong statement. First option. Second option, can kill virally infected cell and tumor cell. So that's what we are calling it as killer cells. Produce chemicals like perforin. It releases a chemical called perforin. And fourth option, they are a part of innate immunity. Correct only. So which is that not suitable one? First option. So instead of cytokine barrier, they have to give cellular barrier. So this is the correct option, first one. So then followed by question number 164. Different types of marsupials names they have given. So these are examples for, so like Australian bandicoot will be there, omcat will be there, Tasmanian wolf is there, sugar glider is there. All these are the different examples comes under adaptive radiation. In evolution chapter, we have already discussed now. So adaptive radiation. Homoplasty is nothing but, so these organisms will have trait in the sense what? Character. Acquired from different species. Why they will get like this from different species like this? Why it will happen means due to change in the geographical habitat. So that may leads to adaptation there, and thereby they'll change the both morphology and genetically. So they'll acquire the different characters from different species. So convergent evolution in the sense more than one adaptive radiation that may lead to convergent evolution, or we'll also call it as adaptive convergence. You have to remember first option, adaptive radiation examples they have mentioned. Next, 165. The receptors for opioids are present in opioid receptor. This is direct question they have taken from Human Health and Disease in that opioids they have taken. So receptors of opioids are present in CNS and gastrointestinal tract. Fourth option. Next, move to 166. Which of the following had smallest brain capacity? Usually Neanderthals will have 1450 and 600 to 900 you will find. 650 to 800 you will find. 900 in Homo erectus you will find. So 1400 cc you will find in Homo sapiens. Which is the smallest in these four? Homo habilis. Next, 167. Which of the following is a diploblastic? Paramecium is not diploblastic. Why? Because these are protoplasmic grade. Entamoeba, protoplasmic grade. Schistosoma means blood flow will come. Blood flow comes under flatworms. Flatworms will have triploblastic nature. What remains out of four option? Panetula. Panetula means C-pen. C-pen belongs to Cnidaria. Cnidaria will have diploblastic nature. Then followed by 168. If Henle's loop were absent from mammalian nephron, so which of the following is to be expected? So one thing I'll tell you, always a loop of Henle will be involved in concentration of urine. If loop of Henle will be absent, means what will happen? So formation of dilution of urine takes place. So what will happen out of four options? Urine will be more dilute. Why? Because of due to absence of loop of Henle. This is a direct answer only from this question. So diagram they have given in question number 169. So A will be the isthmus, B will be the ampulla, D will be the fallopian tube, C will be the infundibulum, E will be the ovary, and this is ovarian fundus. So direct answer will be the third option. Next, move to question number 170. Convergent evolution is shown by. Convergent evolution examples are analogous organs. Homologous organs are examples of divergent evolution. Divergent evolution. Vestigial organs are examples of connecting link. Connecting link. So option second will be the correct answer. Then followed by 171. The naturalist who worked in Malay archipelago. In the same period when that Charles Darwin was explained about the natural selection theory, at that time, same time, one more scientist has naturalist gave that same explanation what he gave. So what's his name? A.R. Welles, Alfred Welles, at the same time of this Darwin. So A.I. Oparin and Haldane. In evolution, you have studied about Oparin and Haldane. So they have explained about the chemical evolution. They explained about chemical evolution theory. Lamarr explained about Lamarckism. What is there in Lamarckism? Acquired character. He explained about how acquired character may come from generation to generation. Next, move to question number 172. Incorrect statement regarding mammalian cerebellum. Cerebellum will have highly branched gray and white matter. This is correct only. Presence of cavity. Which cavity will find? Cerebellar cavity will be there. Correct only. It is seat for balancing and equilibrium. Correct only. Body balanced by cerebellum. So presence of gyrus. Usually gyrus and sulci will find in cerebrum, outer parts. That's what we have this memory, speech and all now by these presence of this sulci and gyrus. So fourth option is the correct answer. So you will not find in mammalian cerebellum. So next followed by 173. Find out the correct matching pair from the following. Hyperglycemia, glucagon. Is it or not? So hyperglycemia. Hyper means increased glucose level. Why? Because of due to release of which hormone? Glucagon. Antagonistic to glucagon will be insulin. If insulin secretion is more, means what will happen? It leads to hypoglycemia. In diabetic patient, always less secretion of insulin takes place. Instead of less secretion, it starts more secreting, means it leads to less glucose content in the bloodstream. That is called hypoglycemia. So calcitonin, parathyroid. So parathyroid will increase the calcium balance in the blood, but calcitonin will regulate or decrease. So vitamin D, cretinism. Vitamin D is related to rickets. Wrong one. Thyroxine is related to iodine deficiency. That is nothing but goitre. Instead of goitre, they have mentioned as rickets. This is also wrong one. What is that correct match? First option. So next to move to question number 174, thymosine. So thymosine is it is a hormone secreted from walls of hearts. Atrial myocytes will release this hormone. So that is involved in release of T lymphocytes. Milk secretion by prolactin. Then erythrocytes in bone marrow. Production takes place in bone marrow. Melanocytes, especially by maintained by MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone, that is pigmentation. Then which is that name of this organism? Next, 175, penetula means C-pen. I've already told you C-pen belongs to Cylentrata. This is not diagram related to Cylentrata. Gorgonia again, C-fan. C-fan is not related with this diagram. Pleurobranchia, this is related. Pleurobranchia belonging to Tenophora. Tenophoran. One of the Tenophoran example is pleurobranchia. So this organism is called pleurobranchia. Eusporangia related to bath sponge, commonly called bath sponge. So these are belongings to phylum Porifera. So answer will be third option, 175-3. Next, 176, read the following statements and select the correct option. Circulatory system in arthropod is closed type. This is wrong one. Always arthropods will have open circulation. You have to remember. Then next, second B, parapodia in annelida helps in swimming. Is it or not? In aquatic annelidans, the parapodia are the locomotor organs. Phylum Mollusca is the second largest phylum. Correct only. Ascale means are dioecious. Dioecious means what? Sexes are separate. If sexes are separate, that condition is called dioecious. Usually in roundworms, na Ascaris, you can take example. As male and a female Ascaris, you can easily distinguish. No, why? Because the sexes are separate and sexual dimorphism is there. So this is correct only. Now answer A alone is the correct answer. A only wrong and remaining all are correct. Next, move to 177. Columns is there. Salivary amylase is related to breakdown of starch, hydrolysis of starch. Bile salts related to emulsification of fats. Renin is related to protein digestion. Pepsin is related to protein digestion. Renin is milk protein, milk curdling enzyme. Steopsin is related to lipids, pancreatic lipase involved in lipid digestion process. So now for this question, answer will be salivary amylase. A3, here A3 will be the B5 will be the C2, milk protein will be the, then D1, protein digestion, steopsin, lipids. Fourth option will be the correct answer. So next, move to question number 178. The inheritance of ABO blood group in human is example for. ABO blood group example is example for multiple allelism. So multiple epistasis gene you have not studied. This is not related with this. Pleiotropy, single gene, many trait, like sickle cell anemia. In the previous class, we have already discussed sickle cell anemia or phenylketonuria, etc. Then what about polygenic inheritance? Human skin color. Human skin color is the best example for polygenic inheritance. Option 4th will be the correct answer. And 179. The maternal and paternal chromosome of homologous pair carry the identical alleles of the same. Identical alleles means we should always call it as homozygous condition. Homozygotes. Heterozygote. For example, homozygous means XX. Homozygote. Heterozygote means one X and one Y. Right. Heterozygotic condition, homozygotic condition. Next, 180 question. Which of the following is one of the recessive character studied by Mendel? So round seed will be the dominant one. Wrinkled seed? No, recessive one. Axial flower, terminal flower. Two flowers will come then. Terminal will be the axial will be the dominant one, terminal will be the recessive one. Green pod is dominant one, right? So out of four, three are dominant and one is recessive. Which is that recessive? Wrinkled seed. Wrinkled seed is the recessive trait. Hope you scored good marks in grand test number 11. Thank you.